Right-wing politician Ayelet Shaked was meant to be here in person. Instead, she meets French-speaking Israeli voters via Skype. The tension on Israel's border with Gaza has disrupted her election schedule.
I'm very disappointed, but I understand about the security situation. She's a woman with an important job.
She's justice minister and number two in the New Right Party. And they'll put her forward for the same job after the elections too.
It's important for us to have women's voices.
If there are women, great, but it won't stop me from voting for a list without women.
The New Right Party has as many women as men amongst its top candidates. But that's an exception. Israel's two largest parties, Right and Centre, which are neck and neck in this election, are nowhere near that.
Only two women in the first 10 spots in the Likud and also in Kahol Lavan, which is a question. You know, Kahol Lavan, it's a new party.
It's better on the left. Small left-wing parties like Meretz are headed by women. Israel's Labour Party has reserved spots for women and is fielding its first ultra-Orthodox female candidate.
When I started with it, it was very strange. People look about, why do you want this? Why it's not for women? Haredi women don't want, but we want.
Despite her wig and modest clothing, Michal Zhirinovitsky supports gay marriage and public transport on the Jewish Sabbath. She entered politics 9 years ago at the request of former Labour leader Amir Peretz.
If she will be member of parliament, all the people in Israel will be happy. And of course, I'm the first one. Whoop, whoop, I can't.
The fight is far from being won. If the polls are right, the next Israeli parliament will be even more masculine than the current one.